the Mojave Desert can seem unbearably hot and dry, especially the way most people experience it, through a car windshield while zipping between Los Angeles and Las Vegas. But here at the Atwood Preserve, the headwaters of the Amargosa River, the Mojave Desert is filled with plants and animals, some found nowhere else on Earth. Thousands of years in the past, this area was much wetter. Rivers and streams once connected ancient lakes, and animals dependent on water were able to move throughout the region. Over time, however, the area naturally became drier. Animal populations that were once connected became isolated and evolved into different species.
I'm Sophie Parker, the Director of Science for Climate and Land Use in the California chapter.
I'm Michael Clifford, conservation scientist with the Nature Conservancy in Nevada,
and these are my notes from the field.
This is the only place on Earth where you can find species like the Amargosa toad, the Amargosa vole, the Shoshone pupfish, the Oasis Valley speckled ace, and the Ash Meadow blazing star, to name a few. Quite possibly, there are more plants and animals to be found here that we don't even know about. You just have to slow down and look closely. And that's what we did for one weekend. The Nature Conservancy brought together a team of scientists working from dawn until dusk and well into the night, united by one mission: to uncover as much information as possible about the different plants and animals living here at the Atwood Preserve. This was one unforgettable Expert BioBlitz.
I love that this desert is big. It's big, it's open, the landscapes are vast, but there are places like this at the Atwood Preserve where the desert sort of hides its secrets.
As you move down the Amargosa River, you can find all these really unique species. There are rare plants that are found here and nowhere else, and it's very exciting to be in a place where you know that you're looking at a population that you can't see anywhere else in the world.
The Nature Conservancy has been working since the 1970s to care for the Amargosa, protecting nearly 21,000 acres through acquisitions and easements.
What we have going on here this weekend is an Expert BioBlitz. And a BioBlitz is an opportunity for folks to get out in the field and find as many species as they can in a short period of time. Those are events that often have a public education component. But what we've done is we've taken the BioBlitz concept and we've professionalized it. So we're here with a team of expert scientists. They have expertise that's very narrow and focused on a particular group of species. They're all here together so they can learn and interact with each other, and they can find as much biodiversity as possible in this place.
The morning of our BioBlitz, we welcome the volunteers who have come from across the Southwest to help, sharing their time, their passion, and their expertise. Their generosity makes this work possible. It would cost more than 6 times as much for us to gather the same information through traditional field surveys done by consultants.
Some have been scientists for decades, and some are students. But right now, they're grouped into teams based on the organisms they study, and they're ready to head out to the field.
The history of this ranch has been that no one has had access to it for 100 years. It's been a black hole of science. We've always thought that there were really interesting species on it, but we didn't really know until we acquired it in 2019.
There's one person who's especially excited to see what we discover.
This Expert BioBlitz is really important to me as the Amargosa River Project Manager because it's going to inform future management actions on the landscape. So I'm out on the ground piecing together where our, you know, biodiversity hotspots are and where we could improve. And I can't do that without these experts coming out to the field to talk to me.
All of our findings will eventually be written up and shared with Matt Rader to make sure that the decisions we make in caring for this land take into account all the plants and animals who call it home. But first, we need to bring together the data that's being collected from across the preserve. We're using a community science app called iNaturalist to make our findings easily accessible to anyone who's interested. On the second day, we take a moment to gather in person. That's because collecting data isn't the only goal we have for this weekend. This BioBlitz is also an important opportunity to foster collaboration and enthusiasm within our scientific community.
It makes sense to have our experts interacting across specialties and across state lines because the environment we're working to protect doesn't make those distinctions.
The Amargosa River is the only Mojave Desert River that flows between California and Nevada, and we have one chance to protect the biodiversity here, starting with the Amargosa headwaters at the Atwood Preserve.
Because the heart of this incredible place and everything that lives here is water. It's a vital resource that we all rely on, including our favorite local amphibian, the Amargosa toad.
These toads are found only in the Oasis Valley of the Amargosa River, and seeing them here at the Atwood Preserve represents a major conservation victory. An endemic species with a small population, the Amargosa toad exists today because of the efforts of scientists, community members, and local businesses who have worked to understand and protect the toad's habitat. After 48 hours, our Expert BioBlitz is done. We've tentatively identified 264 species of plants and animals at the preserve, and we've achieved the equally important goal of fostering connections and collaborations among the amazing scientists who've joined us.
We'll need all that information and that people power to continue to care for this land. The findings from this Expert BioBlitz will make it possible for us to see how the ecosystems change and to ensure that the unique life forms here are able to thrive in the days, months, and years to come.